Hello everybody. This is going to be a project that you can make from things that you have around the house. It's a craft project and it's going to be using things like A4 paper, cereal boxes, pennies, and we're going to make this game, which is one of my games. It's called Treecheckers, and I've got it out of the box at the moment to show you that this is the playing board. That's an A4 size. Now these are the little characters you'll be making, these trees. And these are the playing pieces. You'll also be making these, all the different shapes. And also that's just a little rule book. The rules are very simple. You won't need one of those. So the best way to do it is to explain it as we go along. You'll see the idea. It's a very simple idea, but it's can get quite complicated. So each person takes a go, so I shall start, and you have three different sections here. You have a clear one, you have cross-hatched, and you have a squiggle. And on these pieces you also have matching pieces. Now the idea is that you have to put those and match up the same pattern, and once you've matched that up you can then put a tree in. You've planted your tree. So now the next person has a go and tries to match them up, and I can see here that matches up with that. You see that? But I also see it matches up with that, and I also see it matches up with that. So actually that's a threesome. So instead of putting one there, you have your counters and you put two. So that's earned three, because you've got three matching. That's that one, that one, that one. So that's quite a good move. And so the next person goes, let's have a look. Well, I'll just do this, so. Which is not a very good move, because for a piece like this, you should be able to get more, but that's just the one. So I'll put that in there. And so you go on through the game, and it gets actually more and more complicated as the board gets bigger. So I shan't do any more, but this was just to show you the idea of the game. And from now on I shall show you how we're going to make this, and it'll be good fun. I thought I'd show you a bit more, take the game a bit further, so that you could see how the strategy begins to appear. You can start from anywhere on the board, and as you can see you grow together, and this is the point where it really does become strategic. I'm not sure if I mentioned it, but the point of the game is you must make one square. It's only a square where you can plant your tree. So this is how the game develops. And you can see that things start joining up together, if I can work one out. There we are, there's another one. And other areas start becoming quite interesting. Okay, so the A4 sheet here is 210mm by 297. What an awkward number that is. However, these squares here is made up of, they're 25mm square, and we have 10, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 by 8. 6, 7, 8. That's our playing area, which is quite convenient, because 8 25s is 200, and as the width is 210, that conveniently gives us a border of 5mm. So that's the first thing I'm going to do, is 5mm there. Five there. Okay, that's one border. That's the other side. Now, if this were 300, it would be wonderful, because it would be nice and even, but it's not. So what I'm going to do, what I've done on this one, is I'm going to start with 25. It's going to leave us, what's that, 22 at that end. I'm not going to worry about that. You can center that up if you want, but at this time I'm just going to start putting in my 25 divisions. Do now is I'm going to put in the textures in here, so I'll hold it up so that that's the 25 there, and I'm going to use, you can do any squiggle you want, you can have a few practices on another piece of paper, but you can just do. There, that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And one in the bottom corner. It's a horrible pen, this. Okay, there they. Slim ones. Now the cross hatching is really just a squiggly cross hatch. Doesn't really matter how you do this. Okay, so that's the basic one. What I'm going to do now what colour should I have? This one. So I'm actually going to just colour in the border now. You can make it whatever colour you want. There you have your playing surface. But now what I'm going to do is to just fill in the lines with a felt tip pen. Voila. Okay, so there you have your playing board. before I move on to making the pieces themselves, I thought what I'd like to do is to mount this onto a backing. Now, I can use this cereal packet, which is okay, but I actually have, this is an old sketch pad that I found. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to glue this onto that. So I've got some of this household glue here, and fingers dirty now, just take it right to the edges. Trouble is, I've got to clean my fingers now. Oh well, I'll just do it on that. Okay. Lay it on there, but I'm going to put a clean sheet over so I can rub it down. That way I don't get my grubby fingers all over it. Okay, now I would lay that somewhere flat, upside down, just to make sure that it sets nicely. Okay, so there's your board. Now it's time to make our game pieces. These are the pieces that will be made. They're based on top of a penny. And they're made up from little strips of, you can use anything really. This is the kind of card that you need. Can be a little bit thicker, but this is cereal sheet. I'm using the same sort of thing, but it's just a little bit whiter. First of all, you must make sure you have a straight edge. And then we have to cut out some strips along here. Now the dimensions I've written on here, and I'm going to write on here, because what we must make is we must cut out pieces like that. Now these dimensions are quite critical. That must be 9 millimeters. As that is 9 millimeters, and these between there and there, that's 20 millimeters each, and the width across there is 18 millimeters. Now that's what we have to cut. Now obviously we have to cut 24 of them. So the way we do this is to do it in a length. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to